Hello pupils, hello my dear 6th graders. How are you? Dragi moji šestaci, kako ste? I hope you are just fine. I am fine, thank you, because... Why? Well, we can go outside now. But still, we must be careful. We must follow the rules, right? Yes. So, hello again. Welcome to our English TV classroom. This is your English teacher, Maria. You know my surname, I hope. You've learned it so far, surname or last name, as you like it. Yes, it's Davidovic, and this is our lesson 8, and the topic, it's called, we should do our best. Yes, we should, both you and I, we should do our best, should, yes, should. We shouldn't forget about the rules, not yet, okay? But we can go outside, so we must. You must be happy about it. You know about Mobilco, about the notebook and pencil, everything. And please take a photo of this, what's in front of you on the screen, because this is the, well, what this lesson is about, okay? Have I just heard a lot of clicks? Yes, I have, so let's move on. Now, excuse me, pupils, is your homework ready? I'm sorry, guys, if you think that I forgot about it. I didn't forget. No, because I'm your teacher. I'm the one who gave you that homework. We cannot move on. We can't move on. We cannot continue. We can't continue with this lesson without checking it first. So can you get it, please? Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you so much, my pupils. Now, last time and the time before last, in our two previous lessons, we talked about tenses. One in particular, naročito jednom, that is the present perfect tense. Sadašnje prošlo vreme. Znači, kako mu i naziv kaže, spojili smo po pitanju radnje dešavanja prošlosti i sadašnjosti. A do tad, you see this red thin line, ova tanka crvena linija. We talked about past, definite past, past, when past. Tačno kada, this violet, lila boja, or purple, as you prefer it, and blue. Yes, present tenses. Right now, around right now, or present simple, usual now. Okay? So, homework, translate it to English and answer the questions in English. Yes, in English. You were supposed to answer them in English. So, I did it for myself. Gde živiš? Where do you live? I live in Belgrade. Right? Pa dobro, to znamo. Where do you live? I live in Belgrade. How old are you? It doesn't matter. Or, what do you do? I'm a teacher. What do you teach? I teach English. Okay, so, yes, the tense. The color is here to help you. Yes, the present simple tense. A little helping verb do in question. That's right. Kada si počeo ili počela da izučavaš engleski? U mom slučaju počela da izučavaš engleski. Oh, look at this beautiful color. Šta smo rekli? Radnja ako je prošla. A upitna reč zamenica when ili what time. Koje jedino vreme dolazi u pitanje? Pa neko koje se zove past. U ovom slučaju počela. Past simple. When did you start studying English? Well, my answer is I started studying English a long time ago. But that's the fact. A long time ago, yes. Pre mnogo vremena sam počela da izučavam engleski. Yes, past simple. Dakle, koliko dugo izučavaš engleski? E, sad već moram da kažem. So, how long have you studied English? Koliko dugo izučavaš? Izučavaš, ja izučavam, ti izučavaš. Znači, to je sadašnje ranje na srpskom, ali na engleskom postoji ono što povezuje. Aha. So, how long have you studied English? The present perfect tense. I've studied English for almost 35 years. Yes, my dear girls and boys. I've studied English for almost 35 years. So basically, my whole life, almost. Okay? So, činjenica, present simple. Radnja koja se desila u prošlosti, znamo kad, past simple. Radnja koja je počela u prošlosti, još uvek traje, the present perfect tense. Okay? Da li si nešto novo naučio ili naučila na 7. televizijskom času? So guys, I must be honest with you, moram biti iskrena sa vama. Did you learn anything new in TV lesson 7? Well, I didn't. I'm a teacher, I'm an English teacher. You know, I'm the teacher in this classroom, sir. But more important, zašto did you? Zašto past simple? When did we have this class? Well, last week on Thursday, right, so we all know when the class happened, so that's why did you learn, okay? Znamo vreme kada se održao sedmi televizijski čas. I hope your answer is I did. Yes, I did. Okay? Da li su ti ovi televizijski časovi zanimljivi početka učenja na daljinu? Aha, sad opet ovdje jedno pitanje. Imamo nešto je počelo, još uvek traje. I mean. Yes, that's right. The present perfect tense. Have these TV lessons been interesting to you since the distance learning started? Since, not from, remember. Malo pa je bilo for almost 35 years, for za trajanje, ne prevodimo za, od nije from, nego u slučaju the present perfect tense, since. And my honest answer, I'm always honest, uvek sam iskrena, yes, they have a lot. I hope you, your answer is the same. Right? So, again, zato što je ovo novo vreme, još malo se zadržavamo na ponavljanju i izučavanju, odnosno, kako bih ja rekla, da se slegne sve. Da se to sad slegne, ali baš. Okay? We've been in this classroom for almost 2 months. U ovoj učionici smo skoro 2 mjeseca. Tačno je tačna rečenica u odnosu na ono što znači na srpskom jeziku. Zašto druga nije? Pa zato što, bez obzira što we are in this classroom, znači mi smo u ovoj učionici kao i we've been in this classroom u engleskom jeziku. Ovo for almost 2 months, koliko dugo traži da povežemo prošlost i sadašnjost i upotrebimo the present perfect tense. Ovdje se ne bih mnogo zadržavala. Kada si počeo da igraš kriket? You remember the cricket game? 11 players, 2 teams, wickets. Oni wickets, zanimljivi golovi. Yes, very popular with the English speaking people. Yes, that's right. I mean, native speakers. You know what a native speaker is? Well, Serbian is your native language. You are native speakers of Serbian. Aha, yes, the maternji jezik, native speakers, oni koji imaju jezik u kome se priča maternji. Okay. So when did you start playing cricket? Razumeli. When, what time, have, has, past participle, nikad. Ona nikada ne igra cricket. Well, that's not her thing, that's not her routine. She never plays cricket, that's right, the present simple tense. She's never played cricket bi značilo da nikad nije u životu igrala cricket do sad. Okay. Znači, she's never played cricket je tačna rečenica gramatički, ali netačno u kontekstu naše potrebe da nam kažemo ona nikada ne igra cricket. And ispravila sam 7th date. You remember last time it was 8 and 9. I did it. We learn on our mistakes. Učimo na greškama. Koliko dugo on igra cricket? How long does he play cricket? How long has he played cricket? Ponovo. Koliko dugo? Koliko dugo se nešto radi, dešava, neko nešto radi. Znači, tražimo od kada to radi ili koliko dugo to radi. Yes, that's right. The present perfect tense. How long has he played cricket? I hope now the things are like well laid in your brains. Dobro su se složile u vašim pametnim glavicama. Okay? So, oh hello Abby. Hello Simon. You're here as always. Always keep in mind. Opet nešto da se keep in mind, da imate na umu. Šta da imamo na umu? Think, speak, read, write and listen. That's right. Misli, govori, čitaj, piši, slušaj. What's this? Well, the recipe for learning English. That's right. The recipe for learning English, not just English. Many other things, but for English this is like the recipe, the one, recept za izučavanje engleskog jezika. Again, irregular verbs, pazite, nemojte zaboraviti na past participle ili treću kolonu kada su nepravilni glagoli, ponavljajte, uvežbavajte. Sada bi trebalo taj jedan dovoljan broj njih da upamtite. So, again, thank you. I'm sorry if you think this is too much of the present perfect tense, but please, please do as I say and excuse me if I bore you, ako vam dosađem, but I hope I don't, okay? But never, never forget to what? Be polite and be nice. So let's always be polite and let's always be nice. Now, quiz time! Relax, focus, make yourselves comfortable, have some water or some other drink, okay? And what should you do? Šta bi trebalo da radite? Well, just say it in English, that's it. Just say it in English, ne on English, ne kaže se tako. In English, just say it in English, recite na engleskom jeziku. Šta da kažete? Pa, na primjer, da li mogu da ti pomognem? Da čujem? You remember? Now you can go out, you can play sports, you can have fun. Aha, I can. Mogu, can I? Like, can I help you? That's right. Okay. Ako nam je potrebna pomoć i neko nam spita can I help you, naravno kažemo yes, please. Ne bih dalje objašnjavala, ali ukoliko nam nije potrebna pomoć, ne kažemo samo no thank you, mislim može, nije problem, ali lepše je i vi više volite kada nekom ponudite pomoć da vam to malo obrazloži, it's okay, I can do it, thank you. Naravno, it's alright, it's just fine, šta god da ste izrekli od ovoga, it's okay, thank you. Mobilko, can I can, mobilko, let's be polite, let's be nice, done, ok. E sad, kako bi od nekog tražili jabuku? Na fin način, let's be polite, let's be nice, always. Možeš li da mi dodaš jabuku? Ok, can you give me apple, please? Pa nisam ovde zamolila vas da kažete možeš li da mi daš, nego dodaš. Can you give me apple, please? Dodaš. Aha. Kada se dodaje lopta u fudbalu, pa se kaže kako ono? Pass. E, pa da, jeste pass. Pass je dodati in English. And I said, can you give me apple? Can I say it like that? No, I can't, because... Možeš li da mi dodaš jednu jabuku? Aha, countable noun. Can you pass me an apple, please? That's right. Can you pass me an apple? Please, an apple. Because I want just one apple. Okay? Thank you. A da je samo jedna jedina jabuka tu u korpici za voće? Jeste, onda bi pitali, can you pass me the apple? You remember, right? Naravno, izvoli. Pa kako kažete na engleskom izvoli? Yes, that's right. Of course, here you are. Here you are. Hvala ti, thank you, hvala ti mnogo, thank you very much, a baš ti hvala. That's right, thank you so much. I... So guys, thank you for being here and... Šta kažete? Aj, you're welcome, nema na čemu. Okay, well thank you. You're welcome. Thank you, you're welcome. Thank you, you're welcome. Let's be nice, let's be always polite. Mobilko. Clicked. Have you clicked your device is mobile or any other? Yes. Have you clicked on this? Jel vam ovo kliknulo? Yes, okay. Issa. Let's go back to real life situation, classroom situation and ever disappearing pencils, olovke koje uvek nestaju. Mogu li da pozajmim tvoju olovku? Ok. Dobro, najjednostavniji način, can I have, mogu li da dobijem tvoju olovku, to je kao ono, ali hoću baš pozajmim, ja pozajmim olovku. For example, I'm a teacher and I also have the problem with ever disappearing pencils and pens. I meni stalno nestaju olovke, pa ja onda kako pitam svog učenika, a vi svog druga ili drugaricu, can I borrow your pen? That's right. Borrow is underlined, podvučeno. Stay tuned, you will find out why. Okay, Naravno, ukoliko možemo da pozajmimo, kažemo yes, here you are, of course, thank you, you're welcome, sve to. Međutim, ukoliko nismo sada u prilici i nama je, su nestale sve olovke, to neko pencil pen monster ih je došlo, ukralo, pojelo, lepše da kažemo izvini, ne možeš, potrebna mi je sad možda za nekoliko minuta. Yeah, you know, again, let's be nice. Sorry, you can't, I need it now, maybe in a few minutes. E sad me baš zanima koliko vas je reklo, dobro, sorry, you can't, I need it now, to razumete, ali koliko vas je reklo in a few minutes, a nije reklo for. Sećate se for, trajanje radnje, in za koliko vremena, okej? Okay? Zašto a few minutes, a ne a little minutes? Pa minut brojeva imenica, nekoliko u smislu mali broj, a few. So, again. He's been here for a minute. Bio je ovde minut, na minut. Kratko se zadržao. He is going to be here in a minute. Biće ovde za minut. Okay? Now you get it. Naše za koliko vremena in English in. Okay? I naravno, let's be polite, ne reći no you can't. Just explain why you cannot. Do what? Pozajmiš tvoju olovku, objasnite nekom zašto ne možete da mu pozajmite olovku, vi nekome. Znači, možeš, pa can you borrow me your pen? Pencil, what's the problem? Pen, pencil. E pa nije. Can you lend me your pen? So, in English there are two verbs, dva glagola sa značenjem pozajmiti. Borrow je od nekoga, lend je nekome. So, I borrow from you, you lend me. Understand? Or, more real life example. You know banks, banks, banke. Banks lend people to money, people borrow money from banks. You know, I know you'll understand this one better. At least my, you are my pupils too, but my pupils in my school understand this best. Like banks lend money, people borrow money from banks. Okay, again, if we can't, if you can't lend me your pen, you just don't say, no, I can't, I need it. You're more polite, you say, I'm sorry, I can't. Pišem domaći sad. Pa kako je sad? Pišem domaći sad. I write my homework now. Al sad, right now. Oh, that's right. I'm writing my homework now. The present continuous or present progressive. Možda kasnije, maybe later. E, kad ovako lepo kažemo, onda dobijemo, oh, thank you, or kažete you're welcome i sve po redu i mobilko. Have you clicked? Ok. Now, sve uz ono I'm sorry, excuse me, please, you're welcome, thank you. Can i can't, njegov odrični oblik. O čemu smo da osetili? Šta smo stvari, o čemu smo pričali, šta se ovde dešavalo? Pa dešavalo se da smo izražavali molbe, da smo bili zahvalni, da smo se izvinjavali. Šta smo? Polite, nice, učtivi, mobilko. This is not just for English, this is like for all time, every situation in your lives. Be polite, okay? You know that. Now, you must use your phones in class. You have to use your phones in class. Šta li je sad ovo? Šta vam govorim ja? Pa jeste, morate da koristite sad telefone na času. Jeste, telefone ili tablete, iPade, šta god, bilo šta što može da fotografiše. Jeste, aha. Morate pa morate. Dobro. You mustn't use your phone in class. E, to je bilo ono i bit će kad se vratimo, osim uz ako ne radimo nešto sad ili ne radite nešto sa pametnim telefonima na času, u smislu, sa ciljem usvajanja i poboljšanja, improvement of your English, Must, moraš, moraš, morate, morate, you mustn't.
Šta je beše to?
Pa ne smete, jeste u školi, inače ne smete, osim uz dozvolu nastavnika. Mobilko, stay tuned, we'll get to the bottom of this. Stižemo do objašnjenja svega ovoga. Done? Have you clicked? I like it today to say, have you clicked? Okay. Da, can?
Moći.
Can I help you, mogu li da ti pomognem? Can I borrow, mogu li da pozajmim? Dobro. No, you can't, I'm writing my homework. Ne možeš. Pay attention to cannot. It's not cannot, but cannot. Znači, ovaj glagol u punom obliku piše se the spelling rule is together with not. The only one. Okay, jedino u engleskom jeziku. Zašto? Ne pitajte me, ne znam. Must, morati, have to, također morati. To isto znamo. Mustn't, ne mustn't, molim vas, ne smeti. Must not, sve u redu, sve po pravilu, odvojeno. Pa gde je onda ne morati? Do sad ja sve nešto moraš, ne smeš. Pa u engleskom postoje dva glagola morati. Must i have to. Ali to smo već do sad zaključili. Ajmo sad vidimo. I must listen to my parents. They really want what is best for me. I have to listen to my parents now because it's a state of emergency. I must listen to my parents, moram da slušam svoje roditelje. I have to listen to my parents, moram da slušam svoje roditelje. Opet smo stigli do onoga na srpskom, isto na engleskom, različito. But there is quite a logic here. Postoje logika. Pazi sad. I want. When I say I must, I say I want. This, because my parents love me, I love them, and they really want what is best for me. So basically, I must, I want to do that. E, to je to morati koja ja sebi kažem da moram. Hoću da moram. I have to listen, moram da slušam roditelje, zato što je sada vanredno stanje. Još uvek, dok sada kada ja ovo snimam, prosto jedni ste mali jasno, toliko mali jasno vam je da ne snimam ovo dan kada gledate čas, sada kada gledate čas, snimljen je ranije, još uvek je state of emergency, ali nadam se da dok vi sada ovo gledate i slušate pažljivo i think i speak i sve ono radite, više nije state of emergency, but still there are rules, to znam, da su još uvek postoje pravila. But you have to listen to your parents. Zašto? Pa zato što postoji pravilo, zato što roditelji znaju bolje kako treba da se ponašate i to pravilo, neću sad reći nameću vam roditelji, ne. To pravilo postoji da bi ga vi slušali, da bi slušali roditelje, da bi slušali pravilo koje je u krajnjoj liniji zakon. Razumete? Znači, kad vam ja kažem you must use your phones or you have to use your phones, svejedno je, morate pa morate. Kad kažete za sebe I must, znači da vi sebi to nešto, uslovno rečeno, namećete tu neku obavezu. Kad kaže sebi I have to, time dajete do znanja da obaveza dolazi sa strane. Okay? And there is a difference. Just this. Just that. Okay? Nothing else. So, if I... Okay, let's get back into the past or let's go into the future and imagine one normal school day. So I have classes in the morning and the previous evening I say I have to get up early. Why? Because my class starts at 8. Okay? Znači moram da ustanem, čas počinje u 8, moram ustati ranije da se spremim i sve to da bih stigla na vreme u školu. Da. Well, tomorrow I must get up early because I want to do some housework. Sutra moram da ustanem rano jer hoću da uradim neke kućne poslove and then have the rest of the day off. I da budem ostatak dana slobodan. Znači to je obaveza koju sam ja sebi nametnula. Nadam se da je razlika između must i have to kada ga upotrebljava govornik jasna. Must je ličnije, subjektivnije, have to je došlo sa strane, objektivno tako je, pa je tako. Mobilko. Clicked. Thank you. Konačno. I don't have to do things like I had to before a state emergency. Okay. Again, this lesson was made before a state of emergency was withdrawn, povučeno. Dakle, ne moram da stvarim da radim, da obavljam stvari na način na koji sam morala pre stanja, vanrednog stanja. This is a fact also. Because what? Well, I had to get up early to go to school to do my job. Right now, I don't have to. Today, I really don't have to. It's still a state of emergency. Okay? Ali ono što je važnije, konačno smo stigli, nije više moraš, ne smeš, nego ne moram. Ne moram. Mobilko? Right, clicked, okay. So, we should do our best. Nadam se da ste fotografisali tema današnjeg časa. Should je također jedan od ovih kakvih glagola. Modal verbs, modalni glagola, tako je. Can i must su modalni glagoli. I hope you remember from the fifth grade. Da se sećate iz petog razreda, mada podsjetit ćemo se sad naravno, zato sam tu. Okay? Have to in ordinary, and I can also say in English normal verb, not the normalan, yes normalan, ali običajen glagol kao i speak, listen, and read, and write, and think, just like any other. Take a photo, please. Now, šta su to ordinary verbs? Pa već vam rekoh, navedoh neke, evo još nekih primjera, go out, play, have fun, well, study. Ne mogu bez study, bez think, bez listen, speak, i to ne mogu. To se zove profesionalna deformacija. Šta znači to obični, običajni glagoli? To znači da su glagoli koji imaju svoj osnovni oblik, infinitiv. Zašto je to važno? Zato što je ovaj oblik neophoban da bi se glagoli menjali po vremenima, imali posebne oblike, bilo u trećem licu jednine, present simple, ili ako je nepravilan glagol, svoj poseban oblik za past simple, ili ako je nepravilan glagol, svoj poseban oblik za prošli particip, odnosno treću kolonu. Samim tim što se menjaju po vremenima, ovi glagoli imaju svoje pravila određena za upitni i određeni oblik, mada do sad past tense is present perfect, shvatili ste da ta pravila i nisu baš za svako vreme posebna. Postoji ona logika i postoje i formule koje se primenjuju. Okay? Mobilko. E sad, can, must are modal verbs. Pa kakvi su ovi modalni glagoli? They are like special little helping verbs. Od svih primjera i svih primjera do sad shvatili jeste, pa i liče na kao na neku posebnu grupu pomoćnih glagola. Mobilko uradio svoje. Thank you. I što su oni posebni? Zašto su posebni? How are they special? Well, they don't change their forms, their spelling. Drugim rečima, nema menjanja po licima, za svako lice isti oblik. But you remember this from the fifth grade, right? I can, you can, or even from earlier grades, iz ranijih razreda. I can, you can, we can, they can, I must, you must, we must, they must, etc., etc., u svim licima, u svim oblicima. Ono što je bitnije i važnije jeste da oni nemaju ovaj osnovni oblik, takozvani infinitiv. Iz toga se ne menjaju po vremenima. So no way, guys, you can say he cans. On može. Or they are musting. Oni moraju sad. Or did you can, da li si mogao juče. No way, guys. No, no, never, ever. Mobilko. Done. Okay. Of course, can you help me? I can help you. Can I help you? I must do this. Must you do this? Kako grade pitanja? Zameno mesta, inverzijom. Does this ring a bell? Zašto rekao posebna vrsta pomoćnih glagola? I do understand that you... Yes. Mobilko. Do you understand I really have to say this? You know? Again and again. You do. Thank you. What I hear? Ah, you're welcome. You say you're welcome. Now, on their own, when they said, with said alone, they mean, well, not much. They need the main verb to have a full meaning. Does this also ring a bell? Je li ovo vas na nešto podsjeća? Aha, znači sami za sebe ne znači baš no. Sad neko dođe uđe i kaže, I can. I mi gledamo njega. What can you? What can you do? A onda taj neko kaže, I can help you.
A mi baš imamo neki sad to problem, ne možemo da rešimo. A mi kažemo, aha, thank you so much, on kaže, you're welcome i tako dalje. You must. Kad neko dođe, dođem ja i kažem nekom, what you must? Mislim, excuse me teacher, what must I? Šta to ja moram? A ja kažem, you must follow the rules. Šta bi drugo ja rekla? Moraš da poštuješ pravila. Aha. Drugim rečima, sami za sebe, potrebna im kao i pomoćnom glagolu, bilo kom dopuna glavnim glagolom, u kom obliku, help, follow, pa infinitivu. Mobilko? Ok. Mobilko, molim vas, slušajte i fotografišite. Šta? Can je moći, već smo rekli šta je nemoći, da postoje morati must, običan glagol have to koji se menja po svim vremenima, kao i svaki drugi glagol. Dobro, ne baš po svim, ne kažete I'm having to do that, I have to do that, slično kao like, love i tako dalje. Zbog toga što je masa ne smeti, have to neophodno da bi izrazili odsustvo obaveze ne morati. Done, clicked, ok. So, please take a photo of this. These are the, like a little story, examples for these modal verbs and the verb have to be talked about so far. Can I go outside? No, you can't. Why can't I go outside? Because you have to stay inside. It's 6 p.m. Must I do any homework now? No, you don't have to. You can have some time. But you mustn't just play games. You have to find other ways to have fun because you can damage your eyesight. Okay. A lot of colors here. So, red, modal verb. Have to, an ordinary verb. Green, infinitives. Razumeli? E sad. Mogu li da izađem napolje? Mogu li, imam li dozvolu? Ne, ne možeš, ne smiješ, nemaš dozvolu. A zašto nemam dozvolu? Ne mogu. Pa zato što moraš da ostaneš unutra, jer je 6 sati posle podne. Ok, ponavljam vam, ovo važi danas kad ja ovo snimam. Nadam se da ne važi kad vi ovo gledate, izučavate i proučavate. Ok? Znači, moraš, pravilo je tako. Jel moram, imam obavezu sad uradim domaći. Ne, ne moraš, nemaš obavezu, možeš, imaš dozvolu da se zabaviš. Ali ne smeš, zabranjeno ti da samo igraš igrice. Moraš, nalaže ti roditelj, pa Boga mi zdrav razum, da pronađeš druge načine da se zabaviš, zato što možeš šta, damage your eyesight, da oštetiš vid. Too much time you're spending playing games and using different electrical devices, korišćenjem različitih elektronskih uređaja. So, infinitive green, modali red, have to se uvek spominje, to znate, zbog must, ordinary verb, a šta je ovo to have fun, podvučeno? E pa i to je infinitive, because in English postoje infinitives without to and infinitives with to. Infinitive sa to. Infinitive sa to. Čisto kako kažete želim da dođem? I want come, I want to come. Ok. Ovo je čisto nešto. Nešto a bit advanced, malo naprednije. Mobilko, dan. So, još jednom, mobilko, pričali smo o modalnim glagolima i o tome kako da izrazimo, damo dozvolu, da izrazimo da ne dajemo dozvolu, ne postoji da nešto zabranimo, obaveze, pravila ponašanja, so on, so on. Clicked, yes. Now, mobilko is waving at you, vaše vam mobilko. You should slow down, you shouldn't run down the corridor. Dakle, ovo je nešto što se čuje u školskim hodnicima vrlo često, znači trebalo bi da usporiš, ne bi trebalo da trčiš niz hodnik. Okay? Should, odnosno odrično shouldn't, još jedan modalni glagol, trebalo bi, ne bi trebalo. Da li treba da objašnjavam značenje? E sad, mala specifičnost. Pogledajte posljednji primjer prvo. I think you shouldn't do it straight away. Pa pretposlednje, I really don't think you should do it straight away. Recimo, pričamo o vašem domaćem zadatku, zaista ne mislim čim sad zvoni za kraj časa, da treba odmah sve da prepišete, smestite u folder, proučite i odmah uradite domaći zadatak. Ne, pustite da se slede. To sam htjela ovdje da kažem. E sad, konkretno, sjetite se početka, let's be nice, let's be polite, always. U engleskom izbjegavaju da kažu, ukoliko žele i postoji potreba da budu učitivi, you shouldn't. Nego prosto kažu, I don't think you should. Ok, to je to. Mobilko odradio svoje. Thank you. Jasno vam je. You shouldn't run in the school corridors. Pravila ponašanja, prisustvo pravila, odsustvo pravila. I don't think you should do your homework straight away. Ok, također davanje savjeta, ukazivanje na neko poželjno ponašanje, suggestion, advice, that's it. Mobilko? Ok. I hope this is not like a new thing, because you talked about modal verbs in the fifth grade, the should is new, but the logic is the same. Ok? Right? Ista logika. Ponovno. And some more ways how you can express, how you can give orders, to be more precise, more precisely. Kako možemo nekome da nešto zabranimo ili nametnemo obavezu na najdirektniji mogući način, jeste korištenjem zapovednog načina or imperative. Don't forget to wash your hands, ever, ever, ever. Look out, there's a car coming. Now you can go out and you will spend more time outside. There are streets, there are cars, there will be more and more cars. So look out, there's a car coming. Pazi, the auto. Mobilko? Okay. And one more construction. Let me tell you something. Let me show you something. Let me help you with something. Okay? E sad. Pre nego što stignemo na green u sredini, I will make you do it. Naterat ću vas ja da to uradite. Pa sad ne mora baš bukvalno da bude naterati, jer sam ovdje napisala naterat ću, jer znam da ćete tako zapamtiti. U smislu, činit ću ja da to ti uradiš. Konstrukcija, let, make, objekat, glavni glagol u infinitivu, bestu. Okay? Najjednostavnije. Let me go, pusti me da idem, dozvoli mi, make me go, nateraj me, učini da. But make me proud, guys, because you have made me proud so far, so make me proud again. Činite me ponosno, mobilko, and, dobro dozvolo zahtev, to zjate, mobilko, klik. Make me proud and write the following. Napišite sljedeće. Take a photo, please. Nešto što morate masti, nešto što have to morate da uradite, nešto što ste had to morali pre 5 godina, nešto što sada don't have to ne morate. Nešto što bi mogli da kažete kada vam je potrebna pomoć i nešto kada nekom nudite pomoć za nešto i nešto što, moji dragi šestaci, bi trebalo da radite i ne bi trebalo da radite. So, Tanya is here again, at least in the photo, so both of us want to tell you goodbye for now. Take care of yourselves, wash your hands, stay healthy, listen to your parents, still, and stay tuned, not still, always. And I will just add, let's always be nice, let's always be polite.